How did he know that that was the northern part of the sky? Well, I can show you how you can figure it out for yourself. In order to do this, what you want to do is point to the first star over here. This is named Merrick. Next, you're going to trace a line from Merrick all the way to this star over here, which is named Dubby. We've created this nice line between these two stars, and now we want to extend that line all the way to this star over here, which is named Polaris. You might know Polaris by another name, the Northern Star. But why is it called the Northern Star? Because it always stays in the northern part of the sky. As I accelerate the time here, you might notice that the sky moves in a counterclockwise motion around Polaris. But why does that happen? If you've ever looked at a globe on a stand before, you might have noticed the pole going through it. That's the Earth's axis. Now, the Earth obviously doesn't have a pole going straight through it, right? But you can imagine that it does. You can also imagine that if you extend that pole out of the top of the Earth, that pole, the top of it, might wind up near Polaris. So, as the sky and all the constellations appear to go around Polaris, Polaris appears to stay in the same spot. But, of course, it doesn't stay in the same spot. Stuff in outer space is moving all the time. The Earth orbits the Sun, along with all of the other Sun's planets. The Sun flies around the center of our galaxy, and our galaxy flies through outer space. Because of all this movement, Polaris actually hasn't always been our northern star. This star over here, named Thuban, a few thousand years ago was our northern star. And a few thousand years from now, this star over here, named Vega, will be our northern star. Eventually, Thuban will be our northern star again, then Polaris, then Vega, and the cycle will continue.